I'm going to be visiting my mom at a nursing home. But anyway, I wanted to tell you that Vicki Ward contacted me. I got an email. She said that Jeffrey Epstein was someone that said I might have complained about him. And I just thought that was ironic because Delita Hooks committed perjury and Dr. Andrew Fagelman, why not? They're like Lance Armstrong was, confident above the law, accountability. The whole thing is a joke to them that they can get away with anything. So Delita Hooks said she didn't remember the visits, especially like the first one when I didn't tell her my name, but I said I really need a bathroom because I have a ton of fibroid tumors and I feel like I'm pregnant with a twin. It's urgent. So Delita Hooks said, oh, I only remember one visit, but she's a complainer. So I thought, wow, Jeffrey Epstein, an alleged, or was not even alleged, rapist, pedophile, predator, who I did complain. And who did I complain to Jeffrey Epstein about? I complained to Leslie Wexner, Ace Greenberg. I alerted Mort Zuckerman. I contacted the Manhattan DA and the NYPD. And then Delita Hooks, one of her handlers, enablers, maybe tied to the NYPD in certain ways, describes me as a complainer. And people tied to the city of New York to corruption that are invested in protecting corruption would definitely call me a complainer. But I was at the forefront demanding way more than we got back, which was $450 million taxpayer dollars on city time. And 911, also known as ECTP, 911 tech corruption, we got back $60.5 million. I'm still complaining. And I agreed to false arrest twice, running punch to my head at a doctor's office. I agreed to be kidnapped by a man with a gun and a badge named Detective John Vergona, who admitted in federal court, admitted that he threatened me over the phone. He yelled at me, I'm gonna arrest you. You're gonna drop charges or I'm gonna arrest you. He admitted it. So why hasn't he been arrested? And his supervisor, Lieutenant Angelo Burgos, appears to be in the database that the New York Civil Liberties Union released for allegedly threatening someone with arrest. And that's Detective John Vergona's supervisor. And Delita Hooks' letter threatening me with a second false cross complaint, which ultimately acknowledges that the NYPD fabricated a mutual third degree, that she's aware I've been coerced and forced to drop charges. That letter is to the attention of Detective Andy Dwyer. It threatens me. It has my name. No one asked her, how did you get my name? Not the Manhattan DA, and I have Jonah Luzzi lying to me that they did a thorough investigation. That was her FU because I criticized her boss, a misogynist, corrupt DA, Cy Vance, who asked to lower Jeffrey Epstein's sex offender status, and it was not an accident. I'm not even gonna say, in my opinion, it was not an accident. And no one would report it. Do you know how many people I alerted via the New York Daily News article? I sent that to the New York Times, the New York Post. I contacted the media. No one would report that until after Jeffrey was arrested, what, like 5 years later? 4 years later, here in New Jersey, Teterboro Airport. That was where he was arrested. So it's really, really sickening. And Detective Andy Dwyer, I believe, got promoted to the NYPD FBI task force. Why? To erase even more crimes? I'm just trying to understand.